SSL 6.
Kenapa?
SSL 6 ininya. Iya, nggak, maksudnya ini buangnya ke sini.
Oh, buang sana.
Iya. Dia kan bukan interface, dia mixer kecil. Ini interface.
Sama mic
pre juga, betul.
Iya, hari ini kita mau workshop Neumann dan Dolby. Oke. Okay. Rundown-nya itu kita presentasi dulu di sini. Nanti setelah presentasi itu, per 10 orang naik ke atas studio, karena nggak cukup kalau semuanya. Nanti saya bikinin grup per 10 orang gitu ya. Siapa yang naik duluan gitu. Tapi di sana nanti nggak terlalu lama, sekitar mungkin 15 menit, kita demoin playback lagu stereo pakai 420 dan subnya. Terus udah gitu kita demoin mikrofon yang MCM ini. Nanti ada, kita ada panggil violin sama guitar player di atas. Terus udah gitu kita dengerin Atmos music. Kita udah setting, udah disetting sama Geoffrey Low. Terus mungkin sedikit cerita yang studio yang baru ini nih. Studio yang baru ini tetap konsepnya kita bukan buat di rental, tetap kita cuman buat demo-demo aja sih, buat demo-demo aja. Lebih ke educate market gitu-gitu. Terus ya, nah ini ada si Joseph Manurung tuh yang desainernya tuh. Iya, kita tuh mulai start kayaknya Oktober tahun lalu siapa ya? Syukurlah 3 hari yang lalu baru selesai gitu. Mungkin kalau nggak ada event ini bisa tahun depan kelar sih. Untung ada event ini kita paksain kelar. Cuman belum perfect, studionya belum perfect. Cuman udah lumayan bisa dipakai. Seperti konsol belum bisa nyala. Karena harus dipasangin loom, kita nggak berani tergesa-gesa, kita nggak berani. Jadi sistemnya masih direct-direct semua, tapi yang lainnya sih oke. Okay. Terus mungkin sedikit cerita background dengan antara Neumann Sennheiser gitu kita. Jadi kalau speaker ini semua yang kita demoin kan Neumann KH kan, itu KH-nya tuh berasal dari Kenan Hummel. Nah, itu saya tadi baru cek-cek invoice. Ternyata saya jadi distributor Kenan Hummel itu dari 2004. Dari 2004 sampai tahun 2008, tiba-tiba di email sama Kenan Hummel bahwa kita diterminate gitu. Diterminate, wah, sempat shock juga gitu kan. Diterminate karena dibeli oleh Sennheiser si Kenan Hummel ini. Begitu dibeli sama Sennheiser, tapi waktu itu yang email tuh presidennya, presiden Kenan Hummel cukup baik juga, dia bilang saya akan rekomendasikan Chandrakom ke Sennheiser gitu. Terus gak lama lagi tuh kita di email sama Sennheiser, diajakin meeting, di kebetulan ada Mr. Ho sama Travis tuh datang ke Indonesia, kita meeting di hotel, terus ngobrol. Abis ngobrol terus sebentar banget kita juga nggak terlalu gimana-gimana, tato cuma ditanyain gini dong, oh kamu jual Kenan Hummel ya katanya, barang mahal katanya, berarti kamu bisa jualan Neumann ya katanya gitu. Saya waktu itu agak nggak gitu ngerti Neumann produknya gimana gitu kan, iya aja gitu. iya aja, ya udah. Jadi ceritanya abis itu kita jadi dapat Neumann juga sekaligus gitu loh, selain Kenan Hummel kita tetap terus gitu. Dan abis itu kan Kenan Hummel dilebur sama Neumann jadi Neumann KH gitu. Kurang lebih seperti itu. Jadi dari kalau dengan Sennheiser Neumann 2008. Berarti udah cukup lama juga sih. Udah 14 tahun gitu. Terus hari ini kita banyak kedatangan support dari Sennheiser Asia. Saya sebutin satu-satu. Jadi kalau teman-teman mungkin ada perlu berhubungan dengan langsung dengan mereka, bisa langsung, orangnya ada di sini semua. Sebentar. Di sini ada Lanslim. Lanslim itu Head of Sales and Business Development Neumann APEC. Panjang banget ya. Lanslim ya. Sebentar lagi dia juga akan bikin kasih presentasi. Setelah itu ada Kenan Phang, ya itu Kenan Phang, Technical Application Engineering, lebih simpel. Terus setelah itu ada Tyler, West Tyler, Tyler di belakang. Itu dia artist relationship. Jadi kalau mau yang minta di endorse, jangan ke saya, ke dia langsung. Kejar aja langsung. Terus selain Tyler ada Wenping. Wenping itu marketing manager. Kalau perlu apa-apa, support juga boleh juga nama-nama dia. Ada Zul. Okay. Zul can speak bahasa. Zul itu business development manager. Tapi sound engineer yang cukup handal. Okay. Anybody? Oh, Willy. Sorry. And Willy is a country manager. Jadi untuk penjualan di Indonesia yang tukang ngejar-ngejar penjualan saya, dia ini. Selalu minta PO. And then, apa lagi ya abis ini? Okay, ada Geoffrey Lowe. Geoffrey Lowe saya rasa lagi demoin SAE karena dia SAE. Oh ya, on the way. Iya, Geoffrey Lowe. Ya, tapi Geoffrey Lowe juga akan jadi pembicara juga ntar, jadi bisa langsung. Saya oper langsung ke Lens ya. Silakan, please Lens. Thank you.
Thanks, Pop. I can't speak Bahasa, so please bear with the English. So my name is Lance Lim. So I'm from Singapore. I want to thank Park Sitiari for inviting us here to share more about Neumann, and of course to work with him to show you guys his new, very nice new studio upstairs, which you can visit later on. So a little bit about myself. I've not been long with Neumann, maybe about 5 months, but about 15 years ago I was with Sennheiser for a period of time. Then I moved to Avid Technologies, and then I went out of the industry, and it's very nice to be back here again, right? So it's a very exciting industry. I'm very glad to be speaking to all of you here. So today we want to introduce some new products about Neumann. Any point in time you want to stop me, please feel free to do so. Okay, so here's the stuff that we'll be going through today. Of course, I'll explain a little bit about Neumann's journey, where we came from. Then we want to talk about the new products, the MCM, the M49V, a new KH speaker, and the NDH30. And I will have a little surprise at the end as well. So a quick video.
Neumann, a typical German surname. But for musicians and sound engineers, it's a synonym for highest audio quality made in Germany. For over 9 decades, the brand name Neumann has stood for perfect workmanship and excellence in sound for studio microphones, monitor speakers, and more recently, headphones. Founded in Berlin in 1928, the company has created numerous milestones in audio technology throughout its history. It all began with the CMV3, the so-called Neumann bottle, the first mass-produced condenser microphone. It meant a huge leap in development, as it was vastly superior to any microphones previously available. Right from the start, Neumann was also active in the field of disc-cutting lathe technology. And by the time the great vinyl era ended in the late 1980s, Neumann basically owned the entire market. In the 1950s, the legendary U47 tube microphone took the world of recording studios by storm. Its full and brilliant sound and its low noise were revolutionary, as were its switchable directional patterns. A few years later, the M49 even offered remote-controlled, continuously variable patterns. Both microphones used the M7 capsule, which since the late 1950s is produced in its current K4749 version, the foundation of the legendary Neumann sound. Those microphones are still in high demand. Their secondhand prices skyrocketed to astronomical heights. In 1960, Neumann presents the next milestone, the U67, which quickly becomes the new studio standard. Its sophisticated circuit design marks the pinnacle of the tube era, and its look establishes an iconic design that has been copied countless times. Solid-state technology is introduced with the U87, which may be the best-selling studio microphone of all time. To this day, it remains the first choice for many engineers, as its sound has become part of the collective consciousness. That's what a studio microphone should sound like. It's still in production, with hardly any changes, and there have been various anniversary editions.
Okay, so it's great to be in a company that you don't really need to spend a lot of time explaining about the brand. I think most of you here knows Neumann, where it comes from Berlin, blah, blah, blah. But maybe some of you don't know that we were the ones who... Hang on, give me a second. Just to start off with a fun fact, the 48-volt... Do you all know that Neumann was actually the one who invented it? So among a lot of the other things, condenser mics, we also made 48 volts phantom power. During that era, different companies were having different ways to power their microphones. Then our 48 volt became a standard. So among other things, we started making vinyl discs, right? We had the disc cutting lathe technology, and Neumann basically monopolized the whole market back then. So all vinyl records cut back then in the early 30s were actually made by Neumann, by many as the de facto microphone that you must have in your studio. In 2010, we acquired Klein & Hummel, and we went into the studio monitors market. Then 2019, we started making headphones, right? So at the back there, you can try. We have the NDH20 and then the new NDH30. So 2022 is a very exciting year for Neumann. We went into the live sound market. Well, of course, the condensers can be used in the live sound, but strictly what I mean here are the gooseneck microphones to mic up live instruments. And July, just this month, oh no, we are in August, last month, we actually acquired Merging Technologies. Okay, so that's a very big thing for us. I'll talk more about that at the end. Oops. Okay, so let's dive into the MCM. You'll see 9 pictures here. So it's basically a gooseneck microphone, and you will know who it competes against. I don't think I'm allowed to say the name publicly, but you guys will know, right? There's 9 different clips for different types of applications. MC1 is for the violin, MC2 for the cello, double bass, flute, trumpets, also a drum microphone. We have the piano magnetic clips one that you can mount easily inside. If we look at the frequency response, orange being the Neumann KK14 capsule, and the other brand, right? If you look at the lows, the Neumann one is very linear. It doesn't dip abruptly. So later on, when you listen to the demo in Park Sidati's studio, you can hear the warmth of the guitar, and we have a violinist up there as well. The high frequency is very tapered. It doesn't peak at the 5 to 10K range. And this microphone is still hand assembled. The capsules are still put together by hand, soldered by hand. Of course, not the gooseneck or the clips, but the main component is. It's made of titanium, so it's very robust for live sound use. You step on it, it's not going to break. One very important point about an MCM versus a competition is you only need to buy one. Right, you don't have to buy the other one that has the higher SPL as with the other brand. Right, I think you all know what I'm talking about. The other brand, you need to buy 2 different mics if you're miking up a drum set. The Neumann one reaches 153 dB, no problem. Okay, and it's removable. So if your gooseneck breaks after a few years of usage, you can just replace the gooseneck. You don't have to buy the entire thing again, right? So the cost of ownership is actually very low. And why cardioid only? The other brand does super cardioid. Yeah, one interesting fact, I don't want to spend too much time on text, but we actually tested this in water for 20 minutes, took it out to dry for 4 hours, it still works. Right, I'm not saying it's waterproof, but in live sound, there's rain, there's sweat, this guy is built to last. Okay, so target market, of course, rental market, live sound, but we think musicians can also own this. So let's say I work in an orchestra, I can buy my own MCM mic as a personal part of my gear, and I just tell the engineer, you know, please mic me up with my own personal microphone. And it was broadcasted live, and everything went well. People were very happy with the sound. Any questions on the MCM before I move on to M49?
Silly one.
Sorry?
Silly one. Can you use it for vocal?
Well, no question is silly, but there's nothing stopping you. But most people wouldn't, right? It can be, there's no hard and fast rule in audio, right? But it's not made to capture the human voice in a nice way. Okay, M49V, this one is the return of a very, very iconic microphone. It was actually built first in 1951. It was the world's first multi-pattern remote controllable, maybe already on stage or in the studio, and then the engineer can actually adjust the polar pattern from the control room. Right, so that was a huge hit back then. So we were the first ones to do that with the M49V. Then of course, after a few years, there were different series. We stopped manufacturing it for, I think, maybe about 40 over years. Then now, 70 years later, we just reissued the M49V. Bak Sitiadi has two on the way. Okay, we can only build 25 pieces of this a month. There's only 3 people in the world who can make this microphone. Right, that's why Neumann can only build 25 pieces of this a month. Even the, you guys know Neumann mics are handmade, right? But you know, even this vintage mic holder, the bracket is built by hand, right? The grill, the capsule, everything is by hand. So we can only make 25 a month. So there is already a queue for these microphones. But what we did quite special with this one was we added two modern options. You can actually extend the low frequency range down to 12 hertz. Excuse me. To 12 hertz so that you can capture a wider range, and you can also have an option to choose a fixed cardioid pattern, right? If you choose a fixed cardioid pattern, you raise the SPL level by 2 dBs, right? If you don't want, you can have the standard remote controllable one. Any questions on the 49? This one can capture vocal for sure. Okay, so the set comes with the remote control, the power supply, and a flight case, and the mic clamp. Okay, so now I move on to KH150. Now, we introduced this, we will be launching this on Monday, 22nd August, so you guys are the first to actually hear about it. Okay, it's Neumann's first 6.5-inch woofer in the KH range. Okay, so before I talk about KH150, I mean, just generally to let you know what makes Neumann speakers special. Firstly, each model is actually designed differently compared to other brands, right? they do a small, medium, large, bigger, and so on. For the Neumanns, KH80, 120, 310, 150, they are all built differently. Yes, sometimes they share the same tweeters, like the 150 has the same tweeter as the 120, but the enclosures for the 310 is built different from the 80. Sometimes different materials, different bracing. Like the 310, the base ports are behind, right? Other brands, you don't find this. Other brands, they kind of standardize the way they manufacture each model. Okay, Neumann does it differently. So this gives us very high consistency in the mix between monitors. So you can go from different rooms and the monitors will sound consistent. If you ever have a chance to do a ABC test with the 80, 120, 420, 310s, all set up properly, it's very difficult to tell the signal is coming out from which speaker, right? So if you're working in an OB van with a 120 or 80, you bring back to your mixing room where you're using 310s, you get a similar experience if the speakers are set up correctly. Okay, so that's the beauty about Neumann speakers. And of course, they give fast results. They're less tiring. I don't want to go into this. The linear, our crossover points give us very, very good linear phase response in the DSP models. Or if you connect to the 750, you can adjust the phase cancellations at the crossover points. Group delay frequencies, some models, the speakers, all the frequencies, they admit at the same time, rather than some other brands, the low frequencies have delays in being admitted. Okay? Okay, so where the KH150 sits in the Neumann portfolio is between the 120 and the 310, obviously. Are you okay? So if you look at some of the key specs, right, the 150's response is actually very close to the 310. It goes down to 39 hertz. The 310 goes down to 34 hertz, right? And even the SPL level, if you look at the 150's SPL, it's actually slightly higher than the 310's. So it is a very loud speaker. It's capable of very high SPLs, even for its size. But of course, it's still a bi-amp. The 310 is with three drivers. We recognize that 6.5 is actually the most popular speaker size in the industry, right? Serves small and mid-sized studios very commonly. That's why we came up with this. And it competes against a particular brand, a brand G. I won't state which model, right? But that brand MAP is for 1895. Okay? So with the 150, it seems like there's a huge price gap from the KH120. But you need to remember the 120 is without DSP, right? In a Neumann line, the 80 comes with DSP, 120 without, and in the 150 we put in the DSP. 310 also no DSP. So why didn't we just call it KH150 DSP? It makes things clearer, right? But the reason is moving forward, Neumann will make all speakers with DSP. That's the trend of the industry, and we are going that way as well. It makes it easier to do immersive audio, to connect speakers through AES67, and so on. Right, so this one also will come in our standard anthracite gray and white, and there's also an option with AES67. Yeah, single, I mean, in this line, we always sell speakers single. So, OK, Okay, so here's some examples of studios around the world that's equipped with our speakers. In Germany, our home ground, of course, there's quite a few studios. Peppermint Park that records for Korn, Scorpions, Tom Jones, Simply Red. In London, Metropolis Studio, recording for Queen, Eric Clapton, Elton John. Bauer Studios in Germany. Oh yeah, these are all immersive studios, by the way. Bauer Studios in Germany does Stevie Wonder, also using our speakers. And with Tesma in Germany, that does a lot of classical immersive recordings. Then we have Axis Audio in US Tennessee, and Media Hyperium in California that does Alicia Keys and so on. Okay, so coming towards the end of my presentation, NDH30, we launched it recently as well. So this is the follow-up to our NDH20, right? So NDH20, most of you are very familiar with it. It's a closed-back headphone. And then we wanted to meet the demand for an open-back. That's why we developed the NDH30. What's special about the NDH30 is that Neumann is probably one of the only companies, at least that I can think of, that makes speakers and makes headphones. Most companies don't do both. So the selling point of the NDH30 is actually, it was built to align with the speakers. So if you put our speakers in your studio, you align it with the MA1, calibrate it properly, you use your NDH30, you mix it in an OB van or in another studio, you come back to your studio, you should get a very similar reference in both environments. Okay, so the sound image is supposed to be identical to a well-calibrated Neumann's pair of speakers. And the cable is quite unique, it's internally balanced. There's two ground wires for the two signal carrying cables inside. So this reduces the crosstalk, you get a very good stereo imaging. And of course, open backs are more comfortable for long-term listening. You guys will know. Okay, lastly, I want to talk about this thing, the Merging Technologies acquisition. So we just acquired Merging in July. A lot of people ask why, and the key reason is to leverage on their expertise in ADDA conversion, right? And we will come up with an interface with them eventually, for sure. And that will make Neumann the only pro premium level pro audio company that has an end-to-end workflow solution from mic capturing the source to the outputs. Right, they also have their Pyraminx DAW. So all that will come under the Neumann portfolio and will be the only company that can serve that entire workflow. Right? So that's it for my presentation. Any questions before I pass it on to Kenan to explain more about the techie details? Feel free to ask your questions. Right, thank you.
Thank you, Vance. Selamat siang. Yay. You thought I can speak Bahasa, right? No, sorry. I still will speak in English. Okay, for my side, I would just like to emphasize a little bit on the MCM. Okay, I just thought about MCM. So my name is Kenan. I'm from Sennheiser. And of course, I experience in more into radio frequencies, the wireless. Then you ask me why you come here, because this is a Neumann. I still don't know. No, it's just because of probably the microphone can be mic'd up as a wireless. So later I will explain what is this about. So with all these, you can see, quite familiar, right? Whether it's in your house, your workplace. Now we are talking about studio and also live altogether. Why? Because there are some microphone. There are some devices that actually can use in both, whether it's a studio or even the live, right? So as I said, the as Len said, the MCM is supposed to, you know, initially we talk about the live microphone, but yet it definitely can be used in studio as well, right? So we are action in both, you know, studio and live. So as just now, as mentioned, you know, we have the microphone, sorry, we are probably the best input microphone in the world, right? So we have that in our portfolio, so which is we have all the microphones in, and of course, we have the best output as well, right? In between, you will see just now, Lance mentioned about we acquire merging technology, so as a new interface within it. So today we will not talk about this so far because we are we'll prepare more information in the future and we will launch it and we'll definitely tell you guys after that. So when you talk about the microphone, a live microphone, the MCM, as what we mentioned, right? We actually towards to another company, right? The microphone, right? The microphone. So the microphone, yes, we know that they're actually quite a while in the market. And you know, they are a good sound, definitely a lot of a gadget over here. And as us, as a Neumann, we think that we can have more rooms to improve. We're able to build probably, you know, much better. So later on, you will physically can hear it later on the demo. And now I just want to go through a little bit specs between that. So as I mentioned earlier just now, and you know, throughout the years, the industries, they know the microphone over there is pretty well. Then they will ask, hey, Neumann's, you know, since 1928, you know, we start to have microphone in, your guys should have some microphone which is probably better. We can build better, right? Yes, throughout the years, probably, you know, our engineer in the factories, you think about that, and there's certain things that have some challenges as well, definitely, but we overcome that. Huh? Later on, we'll show why, what kind of things that we overcome. The thing is the electret principle microphone, right? So you will see some similar miniature microphone there. They're all like condenser microphone. Then probably you ask, hey, why Neumann is using that track, right? So we think a lot of factors behind why, you know, not using a condenser at this moment, we want to use electric. There are certain principle or there's certain technology behind we want to work through. For instance, because we also cater for this microphone to a wireless devices to do a transmission. So we also think about that flow as well, right? So that's why we want to go into this electric microphone. And we've used this, we also want to raise out the quality, the sound quality of the microphone. So we spend the years to look into it, and we overcome all these challenges, and we can reach what the Neumann quality expectation. Well, we all know about Neumann sound quality, we must meet some expectation, right? So, or spec, right? So this is what, throughout the years behind into this, and we come up the MCM. We want to make it as natural as possible. Right, so later on you go up. In fact, this morning we have one small sessions. I was in the room that the musicians playing, and I also moved back to the room itself, the control room. Personally, I think that it's so natural. It's just like the same as I'm in front of the instrument, and then I go back to the control room, hear from the speaker. It's just like I'm in front of the instrument as well. So we want to make it as natural as possible. Just as Lance is talking about, there are some a criteria or some specs behind, which is the some mounting clip, right, for all the instruments. I will go through later on the photos as well. And it's good for investment because it will last very long. I'm so sorry, Pastor Teddy, you only sell once. just sell one, then you use it so lightly, right? Then you buy more, yeah? So, to mention about the frequency response, we study the brand, right? We study the brand to see how is it. So then we realize maybe we can make it a little bit better. We want to make it as natural as possible, as mentioned. We also want to make it the full frequency response as linear as possible. Although we know that there are, you know, there are certain challenges we can't really as one straight line, but we try to make it as linear as possible. As Lance just now mentioned about, you know, the low frequency, we make it a bit high, and from the top itself, we also want to make it as linear. So we would like to make it as straight line as possible. So you can see here the full range of the frequency as so natural, so real, and it will not cut certain frequencies throughout the whole different instruments. There are some users out there before we launch. We also want to gather some feedback from the industry's player. I think because of the limitations of the number of demo units, I'm so sorry we cannot, you know, during the time send over to Pasitati to do a test, but there are some floating units around, and some of the engineers, they do some orchestra out there. The very, very significant feedback I like this is like, they have only one EQ point to touch on, you know, for this MCM when it mic on. That means it's, we hardly to touch on the mixing console. There's probably a little bit adjustment, that's it. And if you remember just now, Lance talked about, you know, we want to make it consistent, right? The consistence word. The consistent, not that you need one piece to consistent to all the different show, but we have all the productions on the MCM, they all are consistent. That means you have mic up the orchestra, 24 pieces or whatever, or more, all these pieces out there, you are almost setting the same parameter or same setting on the mixing console. And just a minor touch. Well, we have a quite number of feedback throughout the different application, different productions. They give us almost the same feedback. Natural sound, very easy to mic on and EQ, and smooth sound. I always got this challenge because I was not from audio industry. The kind of description of audio, I always confuse. The audio got body, okay, so body. The audio is smooth, the audio is spicy, yeah. So I always confuse, but I think you guys know, right? Smooth sound, you know, natural. And we also, in Malaysia, I actually thanks to Tyler and also our colleagues, Zhu. He also requests, you know, I want to have this. Then we finally we get two pieces where we have a Malaysian sound engineer. They also use it. Same feedback. I thought the Angmoh talk, whatever they talk, right? The Angmoh. Oh. Asia is the same, right? We are the same, not among the different, right? We are the same. So we have the same feedback where it's smooth, natural, and we cover the full frequencies. And easy to mic up, put it away. If you remember last year, I think it was last year, right? The Olympic. This year. Oh, sorry. Well, I thought it's a very long time ago. Yeah. The Winter Olympic, right? So when you do opening, you will realize there is one beautiful lady actually play cello. I think it's cello. Yeah. So they actually try on the MCM. Two people. We never have the musicians photo, but the sound engineer behind and also the musicians. They also have a very, very consistent feedback. Right? They like it. When you just try the first note, you will hear so nice, so natural. Similarly, later you will go up to the studio if you want to listen. You know, directly to the musicians or through the room. I think Vili just now at the first session, when she just started the first note on the violin, wow, feel like differently. And so on and so forth. So we have a couple of them, same kind of feedback, right? Smooth, nice, natural, easy to mic up. I wanted to show these two gentlemen over here when we have also a few tests in one of the event. I think it's Holland, if not mistaken, it's Netherlands. We actually asked them to try, you know, the band of orchestra. So this is what their feedback.
Hi, I'm Martin Nerbeck. I'm doing the front of house for this ensemble, the opening act, the opening concert for this festival. And it's actually my first time using this brand new microphone, and I'm very thrilled to have the opportunity. My first impression, we have done some of the sound check at this point. The first impression is the microphone has got very nice warmth. It's very dynamic and true sounding. So it's really really representing the acoustic instrument exceptionally nice. I think so. Really, we have used it. We are using it on drums as well as. Yeah, actually everything. So the only thing we miss is a choir at this point. It's 2 hours, then they hear. So, very good.
My name is Kevin Henderson. I'm a fiddle player from the Shetland Islands, and I've just had the good fortune to try out this lovely new microphone made by Neumann. It's called Neumann MCM. And I'm very impressed with it. It's a very natural sounding, a lot of air around it, and I think I might have to invest in one.
Okay, so this is the kind of a testimonial so far. And you heard the first gentleman to talk about, he also want to mic it up. He also mic it up for the drum. Exactly. So we are able to mic this MCM to the drum. So we have a drum clips and all the clips behind. So these are the nine mounting connectors or clips we call, right? So we have the clips for the cello and the double bass on the string clips. So this is, I think there are a couple of those, the musicians, they rather like to mount a clip on the strings rather than the body. Of course, the body, we have three types. The double bass clip on the body, the guitar, and also the violin, okay? Later on, probably you will go into the rooms, you can very close look at the clips. The clips difference from the brand, okay? The different thing is we have a very, very thoughtful design. We are able to do like a spring. You open up the clip, and then you mount to a body, you just release. The strength is just nice to grab onto an instrument body. Okay, later on you can try all these things. If you can ask, can touch or not. I mean touch on the instrument, not the musician. Okay. Okay. So this is good that because it's a natural strength, right? It will not spoil or hardly press onto whatever instrument, because the instrument probably more expensive than the microphone, right? So this is the important things. Then of course we have the drum kit. You can mount on the drum. For the piano, grand piano, which is the magnet component, you can stick on it. A normal universal crocodile clip and the strap for some so-called wind instrument and so forth. So you can do that. Okay, so there are 9 out of that. I think more probably most of the instrument can be mount on or clip on already. So unless you have for your local kind of instruments, probably just let us know, see how we can help if you want to mic it up with your MCM microphone. Yeah, so I think this, you can saw this before the slides earlier. So these are how these different clips mic or mount onto instruments. So they have a couple of components between the MCM. They are, in fact, you see the very tiny, very small capsule. There are, if not mistaken, if 8, right? 8 elements, 8 components to make it as a capsule. And it's handmade. The material is a titanium material. I don't have extra. Okay, I can show you, I can throw on the floor and then I can step on it and then it still can work. Yeah, purposely I don't have extra because I hate pain, heart pain, because it's expensive. But it's actually, yes, it meant for that. Why we say it meant for that? Because when in an orchestra environment, right, in the backstage, when you mount it on, everything, it just happened that the microphone drop on the floor, you know, fight crease, roll alarm, you know, whatever. It's okay, it can be used, yeah? Not a problem. As I mentioned, to mic it up, to invest, the any other common brand, probably, you know, 1 or 2 years, 3 years, you might need to change whether it's spoil or what, but we have very, very long lifespan, good for investment, because those are modular. Huh? Those are modular. Later I will show you. Those are modular. Some portion is spoiled. You can change modular. So these are some examples. I think you guys know more than us. Different kind of application. You can use MCMs throughout all the applications. So this is what I would like to emphasize a little bit more, although Lance actually touched a little bit before. 153 dB for the SPL, one capsule, no need to buy two, one capsule can have a full range with this high SPL. This is the reason why I'm here, because we have a cables that you can plug it into a wireless transmitters. So not only the wired, but you can turn into a wireless transmission, wireless microphone. Use Sennheiser transmitter. because we are from Sennheiser, right? So we have 3.5 mini jack, limo, both are from Sennheiser transmitters, right? Of course, we also make it to support others. So we also support Microdot and also 4P mini SLR. Okay, although you use other transmitter, we also transparency, so you can go through as natural as possible, right? So we support others brand wireless transmitter also. Made in Germany, I think this is quite important, right? So Germany engineering, as what Lance said just now, M49 only have 3% can do, MCM you only have a group people can do. Right, so not so bad. So the 3% can do 25 unit per month, right? This is actually quite fast, quite fast. So we are able to do it. Actually, all from about HQ Germany factories. rotation, later on you will see those connectors, you will not dangling all the cables because actually the connection is actually rotation, you can twist. Not easy to actually dangle all the cables as well. Yep. Okay. Very dry. Just look at the number, very small, purposely, because we don't want to see the price. No, this is MSRP price. You know, everything that you want to order, you go for Pastor Daddy, then he will actually form up all the price list to you. These are the components that we are mentioned about. We have the capsule, we have the gooseneck, the connectors for the SLR, which is into a wired connection. The windshield, actually put it on the capsule. So this is a main components that you want to have one piece of MCM. The rest are the cables. So the cables is, we have four type of cables I mentioned earlier, right? You can connect to different type of transmitters, wireless transmitters. These are the 9 clips, right? So just now earlier mentioned about it already. And if you decided, say I want to have MCM for violin. So we have a violin set. So this is a set, you just say, talk to Pat Sidadi, I want MCM 114 set violin, right? So then Pat Sidadi will know, this is the full package for you. And so on and so forth. So we have a violin set, guitar set, double bass set for drum, okay, and all those brass instruments and the piano. Woodwinds and the cello. So most probably we actually cover most of them, unless there are some others, as I mentioned. Maybe if you're locals and instruments, just let us know, you know, how this shape, definitely parts that they didn't know about this, then he will advise what kind of clips actually you can clip onto the instruments. So, MCM is part of the input, okay? The best input, probably the best input in the world. Then we have the best output, as I Lance has mentioned about the cache 150, right? So we are not only 150. You heard about Lance said about 80, 120, 310, 420, and so on and so forth. This is the one. Okay, so these are the series of the speaker mount that we have throughout the years. 80, 120, 310 and so on and so forth. As mentioned, 80 we have DSP, 150 we have a DSP, and we have a cache 750 we have DSP as well. Eventually, in our roadmap, the rest of the mon will definitely build in DSP as well. Right. So these are the thing. And let's share about all these reference, and please guess, this is from where? Very good design. Yes, upstairs. Okay. Later on, you can go the upstairs, right, to hear the live instruments from the musician, and also Dolby Atmos, right, to feel the productions. Then play back how you feel. And later on, I will go opposite the glass. I will look at your guys. Your guys should be like that. Yeah? So later on, I will take a video. Then you will see your reaction is like that. Yeah? So before that, I would like to introduce Geoffrey. Actually, he's from Dolby. So he is the one actually do some collaboration with Pastor Daddy's teams. Later on, we will do a demo as well. Okay, so we will welcome Geoffrey. Thank you. Okay, while Geoffrey actually set it up the laptop, we'd like to have some, do you have some questions to us so far? To me, yes.
Yeah. So I own the the Neumann speakers for Atmos use. Mm-hmm. I'm just wondering if you guys have developed any sort of speaker alignment updates so far?
Speaker alignments updates.
Because so far it's only like for stereo application.
Yes.
I think up to 7.1 or up to 5.1 or something. But has it been updated to Atmos format?
The alignment.
So his question was, with our alignment software MA1, have we updated it to be able to do surround and immersive? Answer is not yet. In process, the targeted delivery time is end of this year.
Oh, okay.
Yep. Hope if nothing goes wrong. Yep.
Don't mess it up.
We try. Any other questions?
No question.
Then we ask the questions. And we have some prizes if you get the correct answer.
Yeah.
What?
First question.
What is the new speaker model that we are launching on Monday? It is an easy one. No, this Monday. What?
150.
Correct. Okay, correct. what a question, yeah.
Huh?
What a question. Okay, second question. This one not in the presentation one. See on a difficult one. You must be a Neumann fan to know this. What is our smallest microphone? Not the MCM. Not beside the MCM. Our small. Wrong. Sorry. Anyone knows? Okay, it's actually a TLM-102.
Okay, la.
Good try, la.
Same, la.
Okay, last question. The MCM can be used only... True or false, huh? The MCM can only be used with Sennheiser wireless.
No, false.
No, false. Raise your hands. 1, 2, 3.
False.
Hey, you get one. Okay,
okay.
Thanks, everyone. Yeah. Geoffrey, you ready?
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. And all my friends, thanks for coming, everybody. I think for the last 2 years, we've seen each other enough on Zoom and what's and all that, so I look very different, right? So, anyway, My laptop has very little battery left, so and I know you have been through quite 2 lectures already, and I'm very excited to hear Dolby Atmos and the Neumann speaker and check out the new MCM mic. So I check out already. My reaction also same as everybody, is good. Yeah, and I was just kind of think of it while listening to them is I don't think I've ever done a live show without a Neumann mic. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, so over the years I think So is there like, can you just take out like 400 or 800? Like, it's just check. Yeah, okay. No, it's still there. Check. Yeah, check. Boom. Yeah, okay. It's better. Sorry, this is a sound engineer problem. Yeah. It's just my experience doing live show is just that it's just going to ring any minute and somebody's going to shout over my head like, Jeff! Yeah, like, can you get that out? Yeah, it's still did there. Actually, the low shell, you just cut it. Yeah, I'll use the proximity effect to get back my bass. Okay, so my laptop's going to run out of battery, and I know you're going to go to sleep also very soon, so I will quickly talk about Dolby Atmos, and then we can all enjoy Atmos because hearing is believing, right? Okay, so introduction. Very simple. Dolby created this thing called Dolby Atmos, and there are three important things, the difference to this, right? So the first thing is that it is an immersive format. So what is an immersive format? Number one, when we listen to stereo, it's just a front format. Mono is a point source format, right? And Dolby Atmos is a format that allows you to mix, produce, and experience 3D sound, right? With stereo, there's only a front staging format, right? You can go left, right, front, and back, right? With Atmos, we allow you to pan up, down, everywhere you want to go, except probably under the floor cannot, okay, but other than that, everywhere you want to go is okay. Okay, so this is the first important thing. The second important thing is that it's an object-based audio. So this is the part that changes everything and make people very confused. So let me start at, when we mix stereo or 5.1, we are talking about channel-based mixing. You know, it's channel-based mixing. Hey, that's my good friend. I haven't seen him for years. So we are talking about channel-based mixing, right? Channel-based mixing means you take a sound, you go into left channel or right channel, and then you press it to that channel, left channel, right channel. Or in 5.1, you'd have more channels, six channels to play with, right? Okay, so what happened in Atmos, right, is we say that there is no channel, right? Just think 360 and think where you want to place the sound. We will give the sound what we call a three-dimensional coordinate, like X, Y, Z, right? So this corner is 0, 0, 0. Here is 1, 3, 2. So some three-dimensional coordinate. And then we pack the information with the sound, right? And the difference is that we take that and we put it in a file called the Dolby Atmos file. And it goes to the playback device. And when it goes to the playback device, it says, huh, how can this playback device play 3D sound? So you say, oh, I'm a pair of headphones, right? First one, headphone. How? So headphone, how to play? Oh, we use this technology called binaural to play. So we render binaural into headphone, right? And then we go to a speaker setup. It says 5.1. We take the coordinate and the sound, and we make this 5.1 mix for the playback 5.1 to get the 3D sound. So this way, we are actually doing the second part of the mix at the playback device, right? So you create the mix here, but when it finally playback the speaker, right, the playback device has Dolby technology to decode and playback to the speaker configuration. So this is the difference between all the formats before. Before that, you say, okay, this stereo means two channel, this is five channel, this is 5.1, so it's six channels audio, right? Whereas in Dolby Atmos, there is no channel. Okay, it's just Dolby Atmos file. And at the playback, we say, okay, this is stereo playback, we will try to make immersive with stereo speaker. Okay, it's little bit. Okay, but if you have 7.1.4, wow, you hear full Atmos, right? Because you have high speaker, you have this. But there is also other speaker like soundbar, right? The soundbar have R firing speaker, okay? So it will decode to the soundbar speaker configuration and playback. So the mix is not in any channel-based format, but Dolby Atmos format. Okay, so this is the main difference of the whole Dolby Atmos file. It's an object-based audio format. So what we need to understand is how do we create the Dolby Atmos file, right? And how this Dolby Atmos file is sent to the playback device. So, but the concept is the same. We store the audio, which is all these little dots are the position you want to put the sound. I want to put it here, I want to put it here, I want to put it here. And the Dolby Atmos technology will tell the playback device to send the audio to the speaker that is closer to it. Understand? Or like, totally ilang, it's like, huh? lost. Yeah. But so later when you listen to the Dolby Atmos, right, you will hear no speaker. You will hear, suddenly, although I know there are 12 speakers around me, but I'm hearing the sound like I'm in the space. Yeah, if you close your eyes, you say, where's the speaker? I think it's around here, but there's three speakers here, which speaker? So we are not mixing to channel bass. We are mixing to three dimension. We want sound to be reproduced to everyone as possible, as much as to give you the real life three-dimensional experience. Okay, so this is Dolby, and the thing is object-based, and the last part is it delivers to the best immersive experience, right? It does the thing can give. So a headphone, they can give you binaural. You can also play, the same file can be played back somewhat in a home theater or even a cinema with some conversion, sound bar and even laptop and all these other things. And we will try our best with whatever speaker playback device to give you an immersive experience. Even a TV speaker can give you immersive experience. Just that is CK. If you put speaker, you get more. That's all. Right, okay. So, check. Okay, so the So because of this, many content creators use us to deliver the best experience for their content. So you have everything from Netflix, Disney Plus, and all these things, and the same content from the movies and all this is playback cinema, living room, soundbars, and headphones. Yeah. So this one all nicely product placement, you know, for my friends. Yeah. Last minute I'm still changing, you know. That's why last night I sleep very late, you see. I have to work very hard. Yeah. But thanks for inviting me, you see. So the good thing about Dolby is, and this is the unique thing about Dolby, is that we are a complete ecosystem just like Sennheiser. When they tell me yesterday, I found out the old news that they bought Merging Technologies. I'm like, whoa. It's like, oh my God. Okay, so it's the same thing. We are the ecosystem, just like Sennheiser. There is no Sennheiser. The Sennheiser will take the sound from the source all the way to the playback, okay, to the recording, to the hearing. So same thing with Dolby. We are in the content creation part, right? The whole room, we are probably all the content creation part. Okay, we are making the files in Dolby Atmos. And then after that, what we do is we also find a way to encode the file so that it becomes small enough to be transmitted, right? Like in a cinema, you don't need this because you can take a big hard drive and go to the cinema and put it in a server. But in things like streaming, Netflix, and all this kind of stuff, right? You need this kind of thing. You need to make it compact. It's like you go traveling, you cannot be carrying all your clothes. You have to put into a suitcase. It's the same thing. We have that technology to compress it. Okay, and then what happened is the Dolby is actually inside all your devices. So how many people have Apple iPhone here? Wow, okay, so good. That's, you are paying Dolby already. Okay, how about Android phone like Samsung? Okay, so very good. Also got money to collect the jiching. Right, so this is where we collect the money. Okay, so this is what we do. So very importantly, we build the content. You pay for the Dolby, and you get what? Best experience. So this is what Dolby is trying to do. Same thing, best input, best output is the same. Same as Sennheiser, also ecosystem, right? You don't say, oh, I just do one thing. Now we have to do everything. Okay, so because of that, we have partners across the whole ecosystem, and that is how we help the technology. There is no product to sell. So after this, don't need to talk to Park Satyati, say there's a Dolby, which MCM I don't have. Only Neumann MCM 114, right? Bye. But I cannot, I have nothing to sell you, actually. Okay, even I want to sell, also nothing to sell. Okay, so we are just a technology, at the end of the day, that is embedded in the whole ecosystem, right, to actually give the best experience, and a lot of people use that. So I see this a lot, right? But most important is this four, because this four I choose for Indonesia. Okay, so Indonesia you have Netflix, right? You have Disney Plus, right? But the Disney Plus is hotstar now, so it's coming, akan datang. Then Apple Music you have also, right? And then Vision Plus also recently launched 2 months ago, Atmos and Vision Service. Okay, so these are the four things important. Then, of course, all these brands is common, and you can find them in Indonesia. So I can talk to Park Satyati. Yeah, the one got thing to buy. Yeah. Okay. So the next important question, right, is that how is it that we create Dolby Atmos, right? Because now you're very excited, this best experience, and we take care of the delivery for you. And how can we create this? So to make it very simple, right? Before my distinct turn red color, is there are only three things you need. You need the most important thing, a renderer, and a DAW, and a monitoring setup. So of course, monitoring setup, you also know which is the best one, right? I don't know to tell you. I cannot say lah, but they say for me. Okay, so later you hear it lah, right? So after this, right? So these three things, that's all. And what we need to do is, if you look at this line right here, this is how we used to do this, right? We get the best sources, we put it into a mixing thing, and then we export this, and then in a stereo container or 5.1 container or 7.1 container, right? This is how we do this. What has changed is, this doesn't end here. We send to what we call a Dolby renderer. The Dolby renderer does two things. One is it creates the master file, which you have to deliver. And it does your monitoring. Okay, so this is where the big confusion is. People say, oh, I am monitoring Dolby Atmos with 7.1.4. Okay, so that means I'm using 7.1, 7 speakers, and one subwoofer, and 4 high speakers to hear my Dolby Atmos, monitoring. But I am not mixing 7.1.4, right? I am mixing Dolby Atmos. Okay, so your monitoring can be anything, depend. So very simple, the price is for one piece. Why? Because need center speaker, sell pair, then one spare. Right, so the price is for one piece. So depend how much your budget, you can buy 7.1.4 is 12 speaker, or 11 speaker plus one sub. So can be 3, 120, 4, 8, 80s, and 710, right? Okay, see? You already have that in your mind, that's why you all know. That's a good sign. See, I also don't know, I was still, wow, did I got count right or not? Okay, but depending on budget. So you can say, oh, this speaker, I just learned, this kanchu means small in Indonesia, right? Yeah, so kanchu, kanchu, I want big, right? Then you buy 420, you can buy 310, then you can have 7.1, 310 also. Right, also can. So it's up to you how you want to do this. So what we do is we have the renderer, and the renderer will always do your mix monitoring and deliver the master file for you. Right, and these are the two things. That's why in Dolby Atmos, right, you need something called the renderer. Okay, and then the master file is called ADM B-Wave, okay, and it's actually a wave file. So BWF, you are very familiar, right? It's broadcast wave format, right? So it's a wave file. But it's a special wave file that is kind of meant for immersive audio, and we are using it as an open source format. Okay, the reason why is this is very simple, because somebody said, I don't want to have a Dolby 2 to open the file. So yeah, open source, you can open the file. Right, so that's why we do this. But if you want to deliver in a Dolby Atmos, .atmos file, you can also. Okay, it depends, this, the four important people, what they're asking for. Okay, so in music, mostly BDF and delivered to a music aggregator, OTT platforms like this, and the encoding again is done by us, right? So this is the main difference, that's all. It always has to go to some kind of renderer. And the renderer creates the master file and does the monitoring for you. Okay? So just zooming it into the kind of like taking a music mix, for example, right? And then you have Pro Tools here, and this is my renderer. So what, and going to more technical details, right? So we actually allow, so what we did is we send 128 tracks to the renderer. Renderer, again, do two things. Do your monitoring and do your master file, right? He creates these two things. The one thing that makes this very, very confusing, right, is that, remember what I said when I first started explaining Dolby Atmos, right? Is that we are not talking about channel-based mixing, right? Correct? But we give you the chance to do channel-based mixing if you have withdrawal symptoms, right? If you say, oh, I just cannot work objects, man. And I just cannot. It just doesn't work for me, man. Okay. It's cool, man. It's Dolby. So we understand the industry. It's okay. So you can still mix your standard stereo mix, like left, right, left, center, right, 7.1. Or you can do 7.1, 0.2. That's the biggest you can go in channel base. You can still do that. And we call that a bit. But then what happened is if you mix in a bit, it will not find the space and render for you. It will find the left speaker and just send this just like a stereo would. If you put left, right, right, it just send left, right. It just goes there to you. We won't try to find the space and, oh, there's this speaker, I try to put this speaker. It will just find left speaker and muscle, let's go. Okay, that's the difference. So you can still do that. And in the Atmos container, you can still do that. So this is the big difference, and this makes it very confusing, right? So before you confuse what is 7.1.4, 7.1.2, and channel-based and object-based, right? Here is the four things. First, we do the monitoring, 7.1.4, but we are not doing a 7.1.4 mix. But then if you want to do a channel-based mix, you can still do as much up to 7.1.2. That's all. Is it confusing enough? Yeah, best. Yeah, that's the way we like to do it. Confuse everyone, then there we go. Yeah, so that Kenan gets the video he wants. Yeah. Okay, so what happens is 7.12 is if you have withdrawal synthesis, you still want to mix in the bed, you still could. You could do a 7.1 mix and have four objects flying around. It's up to you. If you want to do a 7.1.2 mix and it says, Jeff, I have 7.1.2, I have high information, I don't need object. And then I package it in the Atmos file, it's still a Dolby Atmos mix. Why? Because at the end of the day, the summary is we are doing sound in 3D. Right? As long as the sound has 3D information, we can call it Atmos, we can call it immersive, we can call it spatial. Right? This is the difference. You know? This is the main difference you're trying to drive, right? And our technology gives you the power to create three-dimensional sound, package it, and deliver it to consumers worldwide on devices that they are already holding in their hand, right? One object is one mono source. Two objects is a stereo source, if you want to do that, okay? And we send it to a renderer, and the renderer does the rest. And again, we are monitoring 7.1.4. We are not delivering the mix in 7.1.4. Okay? So we are using 7.1.4 to hear our 3D so that we can mix 3D. And if we want to mix 3D still in channel-based format, we can use up to 7.1.2. Right? And again, your bed is up to you. Sim, you want to sleep single bed, queen bed, king size bed, double king bed, all up to you. So, yeah, so you can say, I want my bed to be stereo bed, also can. And then plus 10 object, also can. You want your bed to be 5.1, also can. So some TV station tell me, I like 5.1, because all my thing is 5.1. Then I just add the top sound. Then they also do that. So all their bed is 5.1, because their DME, dialogue music effects, are all in 5.1. So again, like I say, king size, queen size, up to you. Then after this, so we are just monitoring. So later you will hear Dolby Atmos 7.1.4 calibrated room that is similar to this. It's almost similar to this. And one thing about the room upstairs that's very good is for once there is almost a perfect circle. And that's very hard to get. And a lot of studios, I mean, due to limitations here and there, it's very good. But what I like about the room upstairs is we are almost really very close to perfect circles. And we are really, and this is pretty much very close to textbook. So you will hear one that has very little processing in terms of time. And it's kind of in the right space to fire at you at the mixed position. Right, so that is something special. So do pay attention about that later, because somebody's going to ask me a question. Hey, Bang, how come you put the speaker here? People will knock and fall over. Yeah, because we want equal distance. Okay, I can put in a wall also if I want, but equal distance is hard to get. So last few slides. Very simply, you need the renderer if you want to do Dolby Atmos. Too bad. The good news is two things. One, you have to buy the renderer. We give a 90-day NFR, 90-day trial, and it's full feature trial, okay? And it's $299 if you want to buy. But we are all kawan-kawan. If you really need and you are doing big project, call me. I just give you time to do your project, right? Then you make the money already. You say, okay, no problem. I can afford. Then you buy. But never mind. You cannot. You still come to me and say $299 is very expensive, Geoffrey. Okay, no problem. You use Pro Tools, you got discount $99. Okay, then we will find ways to help you the renderer. But if you still say I don't want to buy, I only want to buy DAW, also can. You use the DAW with the native renderer built in. So you buy Logic Pro, you use Cubase, Nuendo, which Park Satya D-Cell, and then Blackmagic Design, all have renderer built in. So you don't have to buy separate renderer to connect. Right? It's already built in. So one software is settled everything. So it's up to you. Depends on which software you want to use. If you want the Pro Tools, Nuendo also can have separate renderer. And Logic Pro also can connect to the renderer. But now the new Logic Pro 10.7 and above is already have renderer built in. It's like a plug-in you put on a master bus. Ableton Live cannot. You still need to connect, right? Just one small little problem. There is reason why we built the renderer. So there are some feature that your client may need that is only available on the renderer. Okay, so when you have problem with that feature, then you call me. If okay, I do for you. If too many times I say sorry, I think maybe you can consider to buy. Right, can I? So those people who are me, you know, I'm very helpful one. So you can just call me and disturb me, and we just party on Zoom until I come to Jakarta again. Right? So that's all there is. And that's it, man. Oh, so you see, my battery hasn't even turned red. So my conclusion today is immersive audio is here. So it is a format that being a sound engineer for, I think 30, 40 years, maybe 30 years, it's something that when I first heard it, it really kind of blew me away. That's one thing that I really particularly like you to think about is, yes, in stereo we could do a lot of things, and I for one have many tricks to expand the stereo width as well as create a lot of depth in the mix. And I mean, it's something sound engineers do for their life. I know nobody really cares about the little things, but we care about those little things. What's different is when you hear reverb in three-dimensional, it changes everything, because this is one thing stereo couldn't do. And have reverb that really move across the room, because in a real room, the reverb is actually moving. And I mean, those who are doing live sounds, which I have done as well, you also know that this moving reverb is also the biggest problem, because you're hearing all the slapback. And you're like, I need to pump more to get rid of the slapback, right? Or do a lot of delay arrays and all this, right? So this is something that really changed my life in terms of Dolby Atmos. So hear that and have a look and have fun, because I think this format is immersive audio is here to stay, Dolby or not. I feel that in some ways, moving on the future, right, we will be more into this immersive sound in terms of, you know, with these new things like metaverse and all these other things and virtual reality. It will make a difference in our lives, I believe. So that's one thing. And Dolby Atmos is an end-to-end solution from production to transmission to playback, the same as Sennheiser, just to deliver that spectacular experience. And yeah, thank you for listening. And if you have any question, I don't need battery. Okay, I'm done. Any question? No. Oh yeah, sure. Okay, so very easy. My name is Geoffrey Low. Right, this is my name. Just remember this glow at Adobe. And if you really want my phone number, I like the directness. Tonight I'll try. I need your phone number. Oh, I have my stack of cards here. Please. Okay. We are. I scared feedback. Check. Oh, so it's the back that I'm hearing that resonance. Okay. Check. Just help yourself, please. Terima kasih. Anybody? Okay. Okay. No worries, man. You don't need I give you a lot. I even give you T-shirt. For your friend. Okay. I even give you T-shirt. Okay. Anybody? So just basically everybody wants. It's like I giving money. No, this is not the license. No, this is not. This is my name card. This is not the license. Yeah.
But you got discount. I got discount.
Yeah. No, I help. So those Dolby is committed to getting content out. That's my job, right? I'm a content relations manager, so I deal with the ecosystem, the producers, the content creators, and stuff like this. And I'm technical by nature, because I was a sound engineer as a profession in my as I was a sound engineer before I joined Dolby as this. So we are committed to build the ecosystem, and I am looking towards more and more people understanding and spreading the word and so-called like this. So, if anything I can do to help, I'm glad to help, and we can get together and develop this together, because it's still very new. So I like the fact that I'm sure all you scientists will listen to Beatles, right? And when Beatles was first given the pan knob and they say, hey, there's no mono, there's stereo, then what they do? you all hear the like 1964, the tracks, they'll put vocal on one side and the band on the other side. And then they think, wow, that's a great idea because it's 100% mono compatible. You just put back mono, it just works like a mono tracks. But as a stereo track, did it kind of work? Nah, I don't think we do that today anymore. So we are at 50 years ago when people first had stereo. And honestly, I think we are not even touching the full potential of what Dolby Atmos can do at this point. So this is something I say. So yeah, my email's there. My number is here if you want that. But I just love that. I need your number. That's how I'll do that. Yeah. And any more question? If no question, then I have question. Then so you can get free gift. Do I have free gift? So I also don't have. Two. Laptop bag. Oh no, I cannot give Neumann one. That one is. No, I have to give Dolby one, right? Yeah. Okay, never mind. I gave you something, right? Never mind, it's okay. I think I have some more. Okay, I don't have big gift. Sorry, mine is very cunty one. But it's big in terms of size. So, it's so small that I have to take it out to show you. Yeah. No, it's not the type that I need your number for one. Okay. So it's a nice thumb drive that is 32 gig and it's got Dolby on it. Right? I think y'all cannot see that, but it's good for you to put the Dolby Atmos files. Because 32 gig is just nice. Okay, so the question is very simple. I'll ask the most convenient question. So what can somebody tell me, right, what is the format that we monitor in? 714, okay, best. That's right, here we go. Okay. So, yeah. Okay, so next one, never mind. This one is, I got actually other thing, I got Moleskine notebooks also, okay. But I cannot think of any more question. So, what else? Okay, so what is the widest bit you can do?
712.
712, yes, that's right. Okay, give you, Thank you. Okay, never mind. Just one more. What is the file that you deliver as a WAV file? Okay, that's yours. He put out his hand first, just in case. He very smart, he know he very fast, so the sound take time to travel. So what is the speed of sound? Nobody know, really? Really, what's the speed of sound? Okay, then I give you what? Blink, no, it's not blink. What? Yes, that's right. He more accurate. Sorry, that one go to him. I was going to tell him 343 at a particular temperature. Yeah. So when you are hot, the sound also hot. Yeah, and you move faster, I think. Yeah. Okay. So the last one, and I think for the thumb drive, because the thumb drive will some. So name me one DAW that has, wait for it, native renderer. Okay, that one at the back. Okay. What's your answer first? Nuendo, okay, best win. Okay, I'll catch. Okay, so I have ran out of question, but if you all want this Moleskine notebook, right? I have 5 here, so who raise up your hand now? Okay, just hold it. Okay, one. Okay. I know you first. Okay, sorry. Okay. So without further ado, right? Please enjoy the studio. I really like the studio because it's the first studio I walked in, and I know I am in Indonesia, and that is a very important thing to me. Like I've been to. Well, I don't want to sound boastful, but I've been to studios around the world and worked in studios around the world, including crazy big studios like Real World. I don't know if you all know Real World Studio. Yeah, and I've actually did a session there, and it's so big that I don't know what to do, right? And suddenly you can mic mics on top of the instrument. I also don't know what to do. Because the drum set is on the floor, and then you can climb up to a like a tier, and then you can put your mic stand. I'm like, huh? Oh, I don't know how to do that actually. And when I first worked in this studio, it left me a very strong impression because I know I'm in Indonesia. Yeah, and I think that's very important because I think studio around the world, they can all look the same with the same color cloth and everything. But the moment you walk into this place, right, and you know I'm in Indonesia, right? And like yesterday, I had the best babi gudang, is it? Gooding, oh, that's unforgettable. So, but that's a story for another day. So thank you very much, and I'll see you upstairs for the demo. Okay, thank you.
Karena keterbatasan studio, jadi kita per 10 orang ke atas, sisanya enjoy the apa tuh, ada dessert, ada coffee break ya.
Oke, satu stand ini aja udah handle overhead, kick in kick out. Terus yang stand yang ini udah cover hi-hat, snare top button, sama yang situ buat tom.
Itu Neumann yang dibilang baru itu ya Pak, dua ya?
Enggak, ini masih telem 103. Katanya bagus buat overhead, jadi kita coba. Yang kick ini kita pakai telem 102, ini pakai U47 yang udah the best, telem 184. Terus ini nanti sebenarnya untuk MCM, cuman kita belum punya klipnya. Jadi kita taruhin si Sennheiser dulu, sama itu MD421. Kita akan jual MD421 juga sih, nanti kalau ada yang perlu bisa cari ke kita. Tapi kita nggak casting ini drum, nanti buat next workshop rencananya sih kita bikin khusus. Nah ini MCM-nya yang udah di-attach ke violin dan ke gitar. Oke, si KU100 yang binaural.
Oh,
buat roomnya ceritanya pakai itu langsung stereo satu ini. Oh. Terus
sama dengan yang Sennheiser yang
Sennheiser nggak punya, ini hanya Neumann yang punya.
You want to
ini ada motor?
Ya,
ini SSL original belum nyala karena kita nggak ada waktu buat nyalain. Jadi ini kita direct semua nih dari mikrofon, direct to Neumann mic 3M, terus langsung masuk ke kontak. Kita pakai Galaxy 32 yang di clock kita atau mic clocksnya 10 mx. Kenapa kita pilih Galaxy 32? Karena dia bisa Atmos, bisa kontrol Atmos dan bisa kalibrasi Atmos juga, di dalamnya ada EQ per channel segala macam. Yang mesinnya udah kita keluarin semua, jadi remote udah jadi remote di kiri kanan belakang. Terus buat atmosnya KH123, sisanya KH80 sama subwoofernya KH750 di bawah. Oke, kita playback stereo file dulu ya.
Como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Yeah, yeah, yeah. 28 frames in a turtleneck fantasy. Parents always love me as a dinner guest. You had the wins, but I'm not a winner yet. If we're trying to make a pass, I'm an innocent. Got a dog up in the club, I ain't bring a pet. I hear you, but you're messing with a bigger fish. Eating over to the pit, lady sings, tell your mum, grab a mic. You're looking like a snack, baby, can I get a
Dolby Atmos, the world's first object-based cinematic audio. With powerful moving audio that transcends from channels to moving around you with pinpoint accuracy. the soundscape sits the mood of a scene.
Go!
Or captures the full extent.
Do you want to know my secret?
Of nature's fury.
Seru-seruan yang mahal ya. Jadi ini stand ini
satu pasang dulu.
Stand triad orbit. Satu stand bisa buat overhead, kick in, kick out. Hemat. Yang ini langsung bisa high hat sama snare bottom, top bottom. Yang itu floor 1, floor 2, satu stand. Nanti ini rencananya kita pakai MCM sebenarnya yang buat
yang tadi.
MCM tadi, tapi gripnya kita belum dapat. Jadi belum dapat yang buat percussion and drum. Jadi sementara kita pasang seperti ini. Gitu. Ruang vokal ada di sebelah sana. Di sebelah situ samping ruang vokalnya. Terus, nah ini MCM-nya. MCM-nya, oh ya nih yang di atas di violin, sama di atas di nylon gitarnya.
Kondisinya adalah ini kalau di kecil karakternya saturation
atau something apa di bawah ini power sih power power power.
This is Dolby Atmos, the world's first object-based cinematic audio. With powerful moving audio that transcends from channels to moving around you with 10-point accuracy. The soundscape sets the mood of the scene.
Whoa, what is this place?
Come on, you guys, let's go!
Her body fell right in my hands, la la la.
Kita pakai stand triad orbit,
orbit cuma ya.
Buat menghemat stand. Jadi kayak satu stand ini dia bisa handle dua overhead, kick in, kick out. Yang ini satu udah bisa buat snare bottom top, hi hat. Yang itu dua tom floor. Jadi kita cuma pakai tiga stand doang. Terus buat hi hat kita pakai KM184. Buat snare top bottom MD435 sama 445. Ini talem 103 overhead. Kick-in, talent 102, kick-up, 47. Sama ini ada tambahan apapun subject. Jadi mic-nya, kick-nya 3 mic.
Drumnya baru juga nih?
Drumnya baru, DW.
Karena nge-build DW ya?
DW Collector Series. Terus, nah ini
batang snare-nya apa
Berapa? Bottom snare-nya ini.
Bottom snare, bottom snare.
Oh, ini MD435 kalau enggak salah ini MD445. Emang bentuknya mirip. Dia dynamic. Dia termasuk mic baru sih. Paling baru 1-2 tahun keluarnya. Vital 100. Rencananya buat overhead drum-nya. Gitu.
Cartier frames and a turtleneck fantasy. Parents always love me as a den against you. Had the wins but I'm not a winner yet. If we're trying to make a pass, I'm an intercept. Got a dog up in the club, I ain't bring a pet. Covered in the ice, I ain't trying to sweat. We can make some bread, we can split a check. But I ain't back and forthing on the internet. When I think of it, bésame mucho,
first object-based cinematic audio. With powerful moving audio that transcends from channels, whether the soundscape sets the mood of a scene, or captures the full extent of nature's fury.
Oh, is it good pretend?